shut the fuck up.
Yeah, let her finish, man.
Yeah, do you think
would it really be so crazy with all the shit that we've been seeing with Nick?
Yeah, his skin exploded off of him.
Okay, it would really start to explain a lot of stuff.
Like, I'm missing my left hand.
I'm just trying to keep an open mind, okay?
I'd say hand of God, but I'm missing one.
So different from your ghost stories.
Those are just campfire stories. Like, there has to be a rational explanation for everything, for all of this.
Does there? In this world, does there?
Okay, you were talking so rational when you separated my hand from the rest of my body.
You told me to.
Yeah, and it made sense.
The bite with which you're faced, cleave limb from torso with great haste.
What?
You did the right thing.
See? She's got a whole poem about it.
No, it's more of a fable.
There's more to all this than you think.
Did she just lift up her eye patch?
Just let me finish. You can decide for yourself if you believe me or not. I don't care. But I think you should hear all of it.
Oh, and we're going back. June 27th?
The next few weeks were long. The cop kept us fed and let us take showers, but aside from that, we barely saw him. Max and I, we talked a lot.
Got to know each other pretty good. Oh, look at Max trying to work out.
We talked about the cop, the camp, the accident, the woods, the thing in the basement, what happened to Max. We just kept going.
Oh, until the next full moon rolled around at the end of June. Or beginning of August?
We needed to get out of there.
And then now we're near the end of August here, like in the current timeline, not what's happening right now. July 12th. Would that be about enough time for the full moon?
I can't take this anymore.
Oh, yep, that's about the moment. You know, it would be better if you heard.
No, I can't take being in here anymore.
Like a little crack of wood where she snapped, just a.
We've got to do something. We've got to get out of here. We need a plan.
We keep saying that. But it's been weeks, so, you know, let me know if you have one.
No, I have
That's
this
really not very helpful, Max.
Loose brick that and a spoon.
Something.
What?
Just the ETBT tiny detail that I may or may not be a fucking werewolf,
you
Laura.
Keep it down.
So what? What can we do, really? We run off into the sunset only to be stopped when
That's
I
what the cop is waiting for.
And kill you and eat you and then I run off alone into the sunset with little
He doesn't know if Laura has been
stop.
Infected and whether she's going
to
change or not.
We don't know if that's what's really going on and we won't until we get the hell out of here.
Or the level of belief that she has until she sees Max turn into a fucking werewolf.
We can play nice and try to get this guy on our side.
What, so he'll let us go?
Or we try to catch him off guard and make our escape.
We've got to escape.
I'm not going to be nice to this fucker 1 second longer than I have.
I know.
Cool. Okay.
Like,
so
the in media res, but I want to be contrarian about this. Yeah.
It's kind of a movie thing only, right?
No.
Hitting someone on the head, you're more likely to
kill them.
Kill them or leave them with permanent brain damage, not just
knock
them out.
It's definitely a movie thing. In desperate times call for desperate measures, right? So I need to catch a bottle and a rag so we don't knock his brains out. Prison break it is.
Right.
I want out of here. I want to leave. I want to get off the plane.
We're doing code names. I have dibs on Golden Thunder.
No, seriously, Max? We're doing this.
Okay.
Just call me Golden Thunder, though.
Okay. Here's how it's gonna go down.
Can a person have a tiny bit of levity?
Next time he opens your cell to take you to get washed up, you jump him. You tackle him down and take the keys from his belt, drag him into your cell, lock him in there, unlock my cell, and then we'll steal his car and just drive right the fuck out of Dodge.
Right, okay. That's not really a plan, though. You know? That's just kind of saying let's escape, but with a whole lot more words.
No, he won't be expecting it. We're in a routine now. We'll catch him in the back foot.
Yeah, that kind of works. That is 100% believable. But he's always going to be on guard with you, especially if the moon is getting full. Well, he's always going to be on guard with Max, especially with the moon getting full. That, and Max is kind of a fuck up. He just has that smug, ignorant nature about him, which is the most annoying part. And...
Ow, ow. Careful.
Really?
Careful.
Really?
The sheriff doesn't trust you now. Well, you know, I want to leave. I don't want to be here anymore.
But what about my shower?
You'll be fine. Okay, so...
Take your fucking clothes off!
Fuck off!
Get back!
Max, what's going on?
We want to keep those clothes.
Get the fuck away from him!
They're going to explode off his body. We kind of need to keep them. Is it that hard to just explain that to her? Be like, hey...
Come here.
Get off of me!
Shut up. Quit squirming.
Should give her like a shower curtain or something. Call us an internship. Okay.
You're not gonna believe it until you see it for yourself.
Yeah, kinda got the feeling of it. So
fucking ask next time then, dude. Jeez.
You know what? You tried to attack me. Trevor? I can't remember what the hell Chris's brother's name was. I think we only saw, like, one picture of it.
Just wrapping things up here.
Calling for help is not going to help you in this situation.
Down to 20. Over.
What's going to happen?
Well, I'll tell you. It's not going to be pretty. But don't worry. I'll be back at dawn.
You're really gonna leave me here?
You'll be fine. Just don't get too close.
A tarp? Can I have a tarp? I would definitely give her... I'd be like, hey, man, here's this clear, transparent tarp. You can still see it, but there's gonna come a point where I start shaking. You wanna lift that above your face, because the splash zone is pretty goddamn big. He tased him, but he didn't get the clothes off him. He's like, hey, man... Clothes aren't cheap. You're not going to win Fashion Week, but we're not going to get those back because they are going to explode. Clinical? Clinical. After being stuck next to the person for several weeks in a cell. Clinical? What kind of fucking sociopath is she?
I don't know. I just don't feel so good.
Yeah, you look like shit,
what
dude.
Do you need? What can I do to help?
I was just hot. Are you hot?
I think I'm relatively passable, like a bit of a Mino Suvari forehead, but it's all right.
There's not a lot I can do about that right now.
I'm just happy you gave me a chair. So cooling him down would have slowed the process? Is that why Nick reacted the way that he did? Initiation. For some people, it's really rough. For others, it's a killer. Yeah, it's not like your werewolf in Paris kind of transformation. That's so violent. Yeah. And that's where she lost her eye. Wait, how did their handcuff get fucked up? Oh, she can actually find... Whoa. Wow, that's a really rough reflection there. What the fuck was going on for a second?
Fuck!
Well, what do you do about that? You patch it up, but you now have some of that in you, don't you? Yeah, a cop could have probably done a little bit better job of positioning her back. And now she's patched up. Oh, wow. What very poignant music do you have? Depth perception is really, you know, important if you want to shoot zombies in the head or... Wait, did you willingly go back to your cell after you lost your eye and shit, or...
Let's see what that bastard cop's hiding.
Why did you go back to your cell after that? That's so fucking weird. Yeah, I don't want to get too close. Yep. No, I didn't want to get too close, but the camera angle made it really hard to get a grasp of the perception, like the depth of how close I was to good old Maxie. Okay. That was worth it. Spooky, but worth it. Is there actually anything within my cell that can kind of help me out here? There's that. It's still there. Wolves. I don't want to sit down. My brick? Can I have my brick? Yes. Oh no, it's just looking at the... Just looking at it again? It's been weeks. I have done nothing with that. You know, I can have my spoon at least, right? No, that just sits me down. Wait, does that sit me down to wait for him, or... No, continue looking. Fuck that, go to sleep. I've done nothing. I didn't even find a tarot card. Jesus, I thought I was going to be looking for my spoon. No, that's books. I thought that was like several different sets of clothing and shit. Wow, he locks the cells and that is it, hey? That's the extent of it. Went straight to a bathroom and got cleaned up, I guess. Took a shower as well. Could probably clean up after myself. Made a horrible mess. I can see why I kind of had to go with a pre-rendered cutscene for the mirror reflections. Out of how absolutely stunning and beautiful the texture work on the characters are and everything in this game. Just can't do reflections. Chariots! The chariot. At the reins of a chariot, we would all feel safe, taking control, relying on determination to make our choices, valiant, but in some cases, foolish. Many seek refuge in chariots, but perhaps in some cases, they're not as safe as we think they are. Chariots! Got you, baby. So there's... upstairs... Yeah, Max, I know. Max, you're not yourself when you're hungry. I'm cautious about where I walk. Because where I go will lock me out of shit so quickly. Here we go. Document. A fax. They have a photocopier in this...
buttfuck
town? To bizarre yet bona fide... A letter instructing those behind the Bizarre Yet Bonafide podcast, I think, you know, I've always heard it as Bonafide, to stop investigating Hackett's quarry. Excuse me, I want to read that. So it is Travis Hackett. No, I want to go back here. Travis Hackett, Sheriff, North Kill, Police Department, North Kill, Upstate New York. Oh, there we go, finally a location. We're in New York. Damn. Too bizarre, yet bona fide. It has come to my attention that you recently released an episode of your podcast that features the town of Northkill, and more specifically, Hackett's Quarry. If I am to understand the context correctly, said episode investigates the mystery of a ghost in the woods. Though the very idea of this is completely preposterous, and as I am sure you're aware, no such thing exists, I'm writing to tell you that the proprietors of Hackett's Quarry have expressed concerns that such unsavory stories could be detrimental to their various business ventures. Or avenues. avenues? I think business ventures is a better way of saying that, but whatever. Including Hackett's Quarry Summer Camp, which prides itself on being a safe, fun environment for children from all over the county. It is with this in mind that I ask you to take down this episode of your podcast and refrain from releasing any further unsolicited publicity about Hackett's Quarry. The proprietors of said land would not be against seeking legal action if you do not comply with their requests. Please accept this letter as a formal request with the benefit of both parties in mind. Respectfully, yours, Travis Hackett, Sheriff. Okay. Not going towards that door. I'm going upstairs first. Wait, so there's the exit. Do I need to be careful about how close I get to the room with the exit? Well, you don't look too rough, girl. Though, I guess... Nope, not gonna be clicking on that one yet. So is Travis the only goddamn cop in this town that's kind of left?
Fuck. I'm gonna need to rest soon.
Oh wait, is there a legitimate time limit on this?
Figures. I guess I can't leave Max. Better keep snooping, or. I could go back to my cell and wait, I guess.
No, I'm gonna keep snooping. I suppose... Maybe you do have to... Wait. And every door is gonna be locked, regardless. But what's with the spooky woman in the woods? Like, they weren't talking about werewolves or anything like that in the Bonafide podcast. It was... More of just a... Speaking of the... The Hog of Hackett Bay, or Hackett Quarry.
56. That means he was born in 1965.
And Hackett's summer camp was established in 1953. One sec. 56, huh? Where did the time go? You're a good boy, Travis. Happy birthday. Love, Mama. Why in the somewhat abandoned conference room? Did you guys get cursed? Did you burn that traveling circus? And one of the people... has this been going on for a while? This issue of the... Wait, is there... That prompt wasn't there a second ago. It popped up like a spooky ghost. But also very annoying where it's like, hey, looking around for stuff, trying to snoop. I bet that yellow notepad has some shit on it. Goddamn guarantee it the way it's lit up. Or at least illuminated. So we're just going to go around the edges here.
I need to lie down.
Yeah, you'll be fine. I know you're all fucked up and your perception is a little bit messed up. Is that a burnt badge?
This can't be doing too well.
You guys did burn. This old sheriff's badge is badly fire damaged after burning down a traveling circus. Does it belong to the current sheriff or one of his predecessors? Oh. So there were posters about Dog Boy. That were part of that traveling circus, but that was only like 6 months ago. Well, at this time, 4 months ago? According to the differing timelines, it's about 2 months in between. Because they got there at like the beginning of July, and... But yeah, well, I suppose... Oh, there was that one day where all festivities were canceled in August. All events were canceled, and I bet ya... Yeah, full moon, July 25th, 2021. Birthday beers.
July 7th.
July 7th is his birthday. 1965 was the date that you put together for that. So that would be 7-7-65. Are we going to find some sort of locker or code? 7765. Wait. No. What was the lock or the safe code that Chris Hackett had for his shotgun shells? Was that the same safe code? It was 77. It might have been 7765. Okay, that looked like it was open before I pressed the prompt to open it. Used to knock me out. Maybe?
I can hide this in my cell.
Boy, you need to clean that shit up, though. That is very unhealthy. Just a big old hypodermic needle. Blech. Nasty, dude. This environment looks a hell of a lot like one of the sections from Little Hope. Absolutely looks like it. Yeah, like the little shop that a couple of characters were wandering through. Okay. I'm going to check out the door on the far end and then maybe try the exit door. And I would imagine that both of them are locked. But you never know if you don't try. And it seems as though we're kind of locked into... Oh, wait, did I try this? No, I never did try this door. Okay, cool. Take Kona, brother. We have ourselves a computer. Oh, man. CB radio system. And look at this
and myself.
Piece of shit. No, we have not exhausted everything. Uh-huh.
Hello?
Oh, yeah, this town is definitely cursed by the fortune teller from the traveling circus. Yeah, 1,000,000,000%, the fortune teller at the traveling circus. They burned it, and she cursed them, and then Wolf Boy went out and started spreading some sort of virus. Yeah, 100%.
Not so much a hint as a slap in the face.
No, it's a pretty obvious hint. I think, wait.
Fuck yeah.
Wait, I didn't get a chance to try that? It was just more of a, wow, this computer runs like shit. That's Windows 98. 1,000,000,000% right there. What is this email? Hey, T, you heard this shit? We gotta shut it down. Can you... Wait, does that say it was from 2021. 07-2021.
They weren't hikers at all, but ghost hunters who went in search of answers and fell victim to the murder...
An episode of the Supernatural Investigation Podcast, bizarre yet bona fide, exploring the mysteries around the Hag of Hackett's Quarry. You mean the Hog of Hackett's Quarry? Come on, man. Get that shit straight. Hog of Hackett's Quarry. The Hog of Hackett's Quarry.
Ghost investigators?
Spectre sleuths?
Sure.
So, what happened next?
Well, according to reports from the local paper, the North Kill Gazette, some hay bales caught fire during the opening night, and that spread pretty quickly. Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke, including the show's leading lady and her alleged baby.
Dog boy. Oh. Can you handle it for me? From Chris Hackett. What's the date on that? That'd be the 20th of July, 2021? Oh yeah, she was looking for her boy Silas. Oh. Okay, well, we got some white noise going on here. Son of a bitch. Okay, there is something with this picture frame. That is... Really? I can't look at the picture frame? Are you insane? It's turned down for what? Hey, hey, Freak Show goes up in flames. Missing hikers, Anne Radcliffe
and Edward Benson.
When did they go missing? At least 5 miles. They don't have it in 4 months on. Hiker's still missing. So can we get a little closer look at that? Northkill Gazette. Yeah, that was the hikers that I thought was, Max and Laura here. Northkill crowned Village of the Year 2021. 4 months on, that was April. And where? August 2015? That looks like it's 2015. Can I zoom in on... Wait, is there a... No, it just shows... Ah, shit. Fuck. Missing cats, missing dogs. 1 sec, I'm not done with that. Is that one dog's name? Dickweed? Digweed, sorry. Missing cat. Sasha and Digweed. Suspected kidnapping, illegal sale, stolen pets. Armin, which looks like a wiener dog. These are definitely developer pets. So, wait... Yeah, that's August 15th, 2015. Dozens killed in fire at traveling show. They definitely, and she cursed them. Last scene. Oh. So that means that at least these two, that would make three. Max is four. Because the original dog boy is a werewolf out there as well. Now we have Nick. But there he took one down. So out of like the five or six, that's what we're dealing with. Anything else to check out or mess around on this computer? I imagine not. I got the achievement for it listening to podcasts and such. And that's the extent of it overall. 911 tips. Yeah. So they've been dealing with this for the last 6 years, practically. You guys fucked up. Your ignorance and selfishness towards that freak show, the traveling circus, got y'all cursed, and everything went to shit right afterwards. Locked. Definitely locked. Okay, well, it was worth a try. All right, time to go lay down. Yeah. That's why Silas looking for a boy. Always looking for a boy. Wait, has the mist died down? Wait, is he gone? No, it didn't render in the mist for a second there. I couldn't see him. Is that a bug? Oh, no, I thought he was in... There's three cells? I didn't realize that he was a cell entirely over from me. Okay. Well, let's get to sleep. You could have just told me. I wouldn't have believed you. But there's different ways to go about it. You could have... I don't know. Alright, so the tarot card tells me that I can
tell me what happened?
Smack him.
I could ask you the same thing.
Well, he wasn't... You told me not to get close, but he has a hell of a fucking reach on him. Run? We've got unfinished business.
You've got unfinished business.
Like what?
Like how you're gonna tell me exactly just what the fuck is really going on here.
Why would I do that?
Because I could be halfway home by now. But I'm not. Because I have to help Max.
You can't help him. He's too far gone.
Help you too.
Perhaps.
Turn around, hands against the wall.
He respects my
Seriously?
Decision.
I am too tired to argue.
But... Ugh. Me too.
Can I get something about my eye? So... Saw the vision of giving him a smack, but I don't think that our tarot card reader is...
So you made yourself at home.
On our side. Now he doesn't trust me.
That's what you used to knock me out with, isn't it?
This is dangerous.
No shit, Sherlock.
Would you not have used that on Max last night? Maybe I'd still have two good eyes.
Yes? this, but it's really fucking hard to do.
It's a cure. You have a cure.